Chessophile Show.
Chessophile Show.
Chessophile Show.
The Chessophile Show.
So this is how your game screen looks. You can see that there are 10 levels and I have set the questions in the increasing order of difficulty.
Okay.
First 8 questions and then 2 puzzle battles.
Okay.
Cue time and your first question will come in front of your screen now. The first question is to I am Soumya Swaminathan. What is the full form of IQP?
Isolated Queen Pawn.
Yes, that's right. So the first one was quite easy. So we'll go with the second one then. What is the full form of QGA?
Queen's Gambit Accepted.
Yes. So since we have 2 queens, I decided to base it on queens.
Nice.
Okay, the first round was easy as it is usually in my show. So we'll go to the second question. Who is the first female Indian player to become a GM?
Male grandmaster or
female? Female. Who is the first female Indian player to become GM?
As in the full GM or double GM?
Full GM, yes. Full GM. Okay.
Koneru Hampi.
Correct. Yeah, Koneru Hampi. So, do you know when she became a GM? It's okay, not part of the question. Just was curious.
It was in 2003 or 2004.
Okay.
I think she became a GM. She was 7th Indian GM, if I remember correctly. Just before Ganguly, if we see the order,
okay,
he was before Ganguly, but yeah, around 2003 or 2004.
You've done quite a lot of homework already.
Yeah, that's clear. No, I just know by memory that she became quite at a very young age, because she won World Junior Girls in 2002, I think.
Yes.
So after that, she became a GM.
Right.
Soon after. So I think it must have been in 2003, I think. No?
Okay. No, that was not part of the question, so you
okay.
can relax. Okay, so we'll move to the next question. The second question is to Nisha Mauta. Who is the first female Indian player to become IM?
Vijayalakshmi.
Vijayalakshmi, yes. So you were like keeping an eye while this happened, or like you knew this from some magazine, or how do you know this answer?
Since I've started playing chess, Viji became one of my first friends in the chess field.
Okay.
So, and I started playing in 1988.
Mm-hmm.
And in 1989, the year Soumya was born, I played my first nationals.
Okay.
And in my first nationals, it was national under 10 girls.
Okay.
Viji stood first and
mm-hmm.
I came second behind her. And
mm-hmm.
She was already, experienced player. She had been playing for 2-3 years already.
Mm-hmm.
She has been playing for a very young age. In a sense, a very young age. And we both have been very good friends and competitors, in the chess world, in
mm-hmm.
the tournaments. So, and that time we didn't have any women grandmasters in India. There were no WGMs in India.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, even my dad, my dad's dream was, my dad was definitely, my first coach. It's quite a known fact now. So his dream was to make me India's first WGM. So it was always a thing to do it well. And of course, Viji and I, as I said, good friends, and we have been following, of course, each other's career. And I think, she's one player who really deserves a big respect from all female chess players. She has done, she was the first person to achieve many feats. So
yes.
This is one of them, becoming an IM at a time when it was not a common thing for a woman to become an IM, especially
mm-hmm,
in India.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
she became the first WGM of India. and the first woman to become an IIM. So I think very credible, and I have, you know, we have grown together. So definitely I've seen her journey together.
Okay. Yeah, that was good. Good to know. Okay. So we will now move to the next question. E4, E5, Knight, F3, F5. What is the name of this opening?
Oh God, I think I have to use my lifeline. I have no idea.
Okay.
I have no idea.
Okay, so you have 4 lifelines, as I mentioned.
I just Google it, like it's the best right now.
Okay. Yes, you can Google it. So we are now letting Soumya use the lifeline. Ask Google for help.
I'm assuming it must. Okay, my guess is it could be something like reverse King's Gambit. I don't know.
No. I think it has a name. I think I've heard, but I just don't remember. I forgot to mention
during the show. Let's say Soumya doesn't know the answer, but Nisha knows. Let's say if you know, you can just lift the piece so that I get to know, and also the viewers get to know that you know the answer, and vice versa.
Right now, I don't know. I mean, I think I've read it sometimes, but I just can't recollect at all. 0.
Okay.
So I got the answer. It's called Latvian Counter Gambit.
Correct. Yeah.
Nice. Thank you, actually, for this question, because I learned something new today.
Yes. I am fond of opening names.
Okay.
Because there are some little ideas that I have, and then I like to give them some names.
Oh, nice. But if you're going to ask me more opening names and ECO codes, I think I'm going to use up all my lifelines because I don't know any of them.
Don't worry. Okay. Yeah. All right. So that was Latvian Gambit. Okay. Now let's go to the next one. What is the name of this opening? E4, E5, Knight, F3, D5.
Let me think. Do I have any clue? No, I don't think I can. I mean, I think I'm in the same situation as Soumya. I cannot.
No idea at all?
I'm thinking some elephant gambit. No, I mean, I don't know. I'm kind of trying to think of some crazy names.
If you are sure, then let me know. We can go ahead if you are sure.
There's something like elephant gambit, is it? Is this the elephant gambit?
Shall I lock your answer?
I think it's elephant gambit. I have read it somewhere. What happens if I make a mistake?
You lose one of your lifelines.
That's it,
right? The answer is wrong.
Okay, then it's okay. So I'll go with Elephant Gambit.
Yes, Elephant Gambit is the right answer.
Oh, nice. Interesting.
There is a book coming by Quality Chess on this opening.
Ah, really? Yes. Wow.
And it is not dubious, I mean, as dubious as it seems, because I have myself played it, and it is not so easy to sort things on the board when your opponent plays Elephant Gambit. So if you are playing E4, E5, Knight, F3 from white side, beware of this gambit.
Oh, okay, I'll check. Actually, I was thinking of more countries around Latvia. I thought it must be named around one of those countries only.
No.
Because Knight of 3 F5 is Latvia Gambit, right? So I was thinking, what is to the east of Latvia?
Yeah, that's a good logic, actually, because a lot of openings are named after places, cities.
Yes.
Now, one thing I want to make clear, I mean, even to the viewers, just because I am asking these questions doesn't mean I know everything. It's just that I have picked a few questions, and there is so much in chess that you know, it's a vast thing. I mean, there are so many things I also do not know. Just to make it entertaining, I pick those questions which are not so famous, like those topics which are not so famous.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you passed this test.
Nice.
So this was like considered to be the first level of toughness. Let's go to the next one. The next question is to Soumya Swaminathan.
Okay.
Who is the first WGM of West Bengal?
I think she's sitting in front of me like
Yes.
Nisha Mota.
Yes, correct. Yeah. So you knew this, or
Yes.
just because you knew this?
No, I just thought for a few seconds because I was like, why would you ask me such a simple question? I was thinking I was just thinking about the question once again in my mind. Like, I heard it
Okay.
right. Yeah.
So
No, of
let
course
us.
I know this. Like, Nisha became a WGM in I think 2003,
Yes, you're
right?
right.
Correct. Yeah. You know
2003, that is the
it?
year I think I started.
Ah.
Really? I also know she's the fourth WGM of India. No, third WGM of India. Fourth.
Four.
Okay. Aarti. Aarti was
Artist.
the third.
Artist,
Okay.
yeah.
Yeah. But you became in the same year. That I remember.
I became in 2003. I think she became in 2002.
Ah, okay.
No. We became in the same year. You're right. You're right.
Yeah.
You're right. We became in the same year. Yes. Wow.
No, I knew this. I didn't. This was not a
Right.
part of my preparation for the quiz.
I think she had completed her requirements or something, but the FIDE meeting was held later on, something like this, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah,
Yeah.
that's possible because at that time it used to be held every 6 months.
Yes, right.
Okay. So let's ask Didi about her journey towards the WGM title. So did you go for the title with like I wanted to get this title and you got it that way, or it just happened without really considering a title in your journey? Like it happened on its own, or you wanted WGM title in particular and you got it?
No, WGM I actually wanted because as I said, when we used to play in our days, there was no WGM in India earlier, and it was a big thing. So when I started playing chess, the dream of my family was to make like my dad wanted to make either me or my elder sister Swati Mota as a WGM, India's first WGM. That was his dream. Like, it's like that was the one thing which he wanted in his life. So, for kids, it is what the parents want that makes a big, thing that you want fulfill the wishes. So for me, I knew, I mean, once my dad was telling my mom and I overheard the conversation and he was just telling that, I just want to make them India's, like make one of them India's first WGM. And I heard it and I was like, oh yeah. So I was really like,
Motivated.
okay. Motivated, yes. When I became a WIM, I became India's youngest WIM in 1995. That came very naturally. I mean, I didn't even have rating, by the way. When I became a WIM, I didn't have a rating. So I got a rating and the title from the same tournament. In fact, Vijay and me both became WIM from the same tournament. So it so happened that we were playing the Asian Zonal. So you scored 2/3. And you get the title straight away. So Viji scored 6/6, and she became a WIM, and she was my roommate also. So I was feeling she scored 6/6. I can't even score 6/9. So and then I went on to make my WIM title, and that came very smoothly. I never had. I mean, it was like not I had to work for it kind of. But when it comes to WGM, I really was. Like I thought I really should get it any day, and it didn't
Acha.
come as smooth as I would think because it was first a race to become the first WGM, but then Viji became, and later on Humpy became the second WGM of India. So I mean it was a span of 2 3 years, but at that time you didn't have so many tournaments like today. It's not like in 1 year you get 10 opportunities like today.
Yes.
So we had to wait for an opportunity for, like 6 months, 1 year for the next good tournament where you can make it.
Right.
So yeah, I think I made one norm each year or something like that. So one nationals I made, one broad I made. So it was like not very smooth. I mean, I had to work for it. It was not like it just came, like many kids today get it, like they're too talented, just it comes on the way. For me, I had to.
Okay.
No, I mean, I had to work to become a WGM. I mean, I really had to put in a lot of effort at that
So that
time.
was one of your breakthroughs, right?
That was like a dream come true. I mean, it's like, it's like the day you start something, you know, you have a dream and then you achieve it. And for once you are very happy, and for the next you are like, okay, now this is my next target. You have to even set the new target, because the target which you're playing for so many years has been, you know, achieved. So, okay, it was a very big moment. And in fact, the welcome I got in my city, the, you know, we had a press conference in Calicut. It was declared during the Asians. So there was a big press conference. So it was like, you know, I was in the newspapers all over, and it was a very big thing at that time. Like today, somebody becomes WGN, they get a small something in the papers. It's like, okay, every day there's some IM, some GM, some WGM. At that time, it was like really a big thing. And first WGM of Calcutta. So a lot of people had come to receive me and all that. It was really a very happy moment for all of us.
Okay.
Oh, nice. Nice.
I know it's written in psychology that if you revisit your happy moments, it also heals you, plus, you know, it motivates you. So it was good to visit your winning moment.
Yeah. And it's also inspiring, like, to hear other people. Like, for me, it was very inspiring to hear about Nisha's journey. Like.
Yes. Okay, so we'll move to the next question. Name the three Indian chess players who have won World Juniors girls title.
One is Soumya sitting right in front of me.
Yes.
I need to think of the other two. Who else won the World Junior? World Junior, Harika won, Soumya won. Three, you said, yeah?
Yes.
Who's one more? Who's the third person? 1 minute. Harika, Soumya. Who won recently World Junior? World Junior.
Yes, under 20.
Yeah, I'm trying to think who could have become after Soumya, who became. 1 minute. She didn't become World Junior. No, Divya is too young. 1 minute. Who is it? Am I missing? Who won World Junior? Harika, Soumya, one more Soumya.
We did talk about this during the show today.
No, I think Nisha got disconnected at that time.
Oh,
then,
yeah. Okay.
No, because Aarti became under 18 world champion. You want under 20. Under 20, who became Vaishya? Let me think who are the candidates who can become world champion. I don't have a time limit here, right?
No, there is no time limit. So you can take your time.
Yes. So Divya has not. Yeah. You're telling something?
Yeah, Soumya answered, that is right. Soumya became a world junior champion. Then Harika is also right. There's only one name left.
I'm trying to think who else became Hampi. Wait, Hampi became a what? Did Hampi became world junior champion? Yeah? Is it? There can't be anybody else. See, Vaishali has won or not? No, if Vaishali has not won, if Divya has not won, World Junior. Who else is there? It has to be Hampi. Is it Hampi?
So shall I lock your answer?
I think so, because I don't see anybody else. It has to be Hampi, yes.
Yes, you are right. That answer is right. So Harika, I mean Hampi, Harika, and then Soumya. That's the order.
Okay. Actually, Hampi has actually...
I think it's so hard to like... you know, contain my smile when you were thinking like...
Yeah, that's so fun.
I gave some hints. Like, I was like, no, I'm competing.
Yes. Personally, for me, when I got to know that Soumya became World Junior Champion, for me, it was like a big news. And I read an article, I think, by Magesh about the whole World Junior experience. And when I read it, I was very inspired. So now, please tell me about your World Junior experience, because I'm very curious to know how it feels to win a World Junior title. Because I haven't won, but I would like to know from your perspective, how was it?
So there were a couple of things. So first was that I wanted to win the World Junior title. Like, it was my aim. And it was my
Oh,
aim
okay.
for a year, like that whole year, that was my aim. So any other tournament, if you see, from 2009, so I won it in 2009. Any other tournament, I didn't even gain rating. Like I didn't play well because my whole aim was I must, like in my mind, I was only working for World Junior. So maybe because of that, I did not really focus much on other tournaments. So it was really important for me that I do well there because I have done all these things to get there, right? And
Yes.
also important, the reason for my motivation was not only the title, but the previous year I had missed out on a bronze.
So that was your
Actually,
second attempt?
this was my fifth attempt.
Oh,
I
okay.
played this was the fifth time I was playing World Juniors, and in 2008 I was in the last round. I was playing against a player from Turkey, and I was exchange up, and if I win that game, I win the bronze. So I was like, okay, I'm obviously going to win the medal. And then during the game you just mess up here and there, and I managed to lose it, and I was like really upset. And that year my friends Abhijit Gupta and Harika, they won the World Junior titles. So it was the first
Yes,
time,
right.
yeah, it was the first time I had seen an Indian. I mean, I had seen Aarti win the under 18 title as well, but for the first time, one of my friends had won a world championship in front of me, and I was really very inspired. They played the national anthem and everything during the closing ceremony, and I obviously felt very inspired. So that really, the pain of losing the bronze medal plus the inspiration both motivated me to do well in this edition. So that was one thing. And the second thing was the tournament itself. It was so much fun, like in Argentina. So it was the first time we got a grandmaster as our team coach. Before that, we had never got, yeah, like before that, we had never gotten a grandmaster for a junior tournament, like a coach. And Magesh is so helpful. I think after the fifth or sixth round, he started, when he saw that I'm doing well, he started to, I mean, he used to anyway offer to help every day, but after the fifth or sixth round, I really started to ask him for help. And every day he used to help me with my openings, little bit here and there. Whether they came or not is different, but the thing is, he really put in so much effort, and
Yeah,
he used to.
presence
Yeah, he used to
makes it.
motivate me, like he used to motivate all the players a lot. And I would like to tell you a nice story about the last round as well.
Yes.
That I was leading the tournament, and I lost the second last round in a completely
Penultimate.
draw, yeah, penultimate draw. So now I lost the lead, and I felt like everything is over, like that's it. So I was extremely upset, and I just went to my room. I didn't speak to anyone, and I just went to my room. And after 15 minutes, I came down. I thought, okay, last round is left, and I thought I should speak to Magesh a bit. And he was just trying to motivate me and everything, and we decided to check the pairings. And I was paired against the same girl whom I had lost to in the 2008 edition in the final round.
Looks like a filmy, no
Yes, it
climax, you
was
know.
so filmy, and I felt like this is my destiny. I mean, I'm destined to win it. Like, this is how I redeem myself. So I again got my motivation back, and Magesh also, he really like encouraged me to give my best. And everyone in the team that night, all of us, we prepared till 2 a.m. Many of the participants, like Adiban, Ashwin, I remember Vishnu, all of them, we were in Magesh's room, and they were helping me prepare. They also had their own rounds the last day, and they were helping me prepare, and they were also helping Kiran prepare, Kiran Manisha Mohanty, because she was playing against the girl who was leading the tournament. And you won't believe it, the last round I got the exact position as we had prepared at home in the room.
Achha, and
And
then
I won the game, and but I hadn't even gotten up from my board. I hadn't bothered to. I told myself I won't look at other games because it just adds to the pressure. So I did not know that I had won the tournament. So I got up after I finished my game and I just, you know, peeped on the first board to see what happened, and I saw both the kings in front of each other. I couldn't believe it, and just went a little closer, and it was a draw. And then I looked at Magesh and Mrinal, Mrinalini Kunte. She was also our manager, and she was my roommate also during this tournament.
Okay.
She was also really very motivating, and you know, everybody was basically cheering for me. And I looked at them, and they were like, "Yeah, you won."
But you were trailing by half point, or you were on the same point?
I was trailing by half point. So she had to make a draw and I had to win.
Okay.
So I was, yeah, so that that's what happened. Like I lost the penultimate round.
Mm-hmm.
So she was trailing by half point till then, and then she won the penultimate round. So she started to lead, and that's what happened.
Amazing, amazing story.
Yeah, this was really amazing. I was, I mean, when I was following that time, this was my first thing. I think I asked Soumya back then that how did you manage the last round? Because, you know, the pressure you have when you are playing for the championship, it's, and that to world junior title, it's like, you know, very few get to that situation where they are playing a last round to, you know, they win and they get it. So this was very inspiring, very nice to hear the story of Soumya. Lovely.
Yeah, and I think I was very lucky to get such great friends who were in the team. Like, even though chess is not a team sport and it was an individual championship, all my friends helped me, Magesh, Mrinal, all of them. They were so nice and they were so like supportive and encouraging. That was, I think, very important for me to do well.
Yeah, a lot of things have to fall together.
Yeah, exactly. Like, it's not enough if you give your best. Like, a lot of things have to come together, and that's the reason some people, you know, even after playing so well, they come second or third. But to come first, I think a lot of things have to come together. That's always there. Yeah.
So, but did you visualize, like, I've seen some of the winners, they visualize themselves on the podium. So, did you visualize yourself on the podium?
Yeah, I did. So as I told you, for 1 year, that was my aim. Like, I was so determined that I'm going to win this tournament, like whatever happens. Because it was my last chance also. I was 20 at that time. So it was the last time. Yeah, last time I would participate in it. And I'd already played 4 times. So it was not even like, acha chalo, experience ke liye khel ke aate, you know.
The one key moment I would like to highlight is that when you got to know that you are playing against the same opponent, a lot of players, you know, they may feel, "Are, aisa kyun hua?" But you felt, yeah, this is my chance.
Yeah.
So that is one point I can pick from this experience.
Thank you. Yeah, it was a sign for me, like, that things are going to fall in place.
Yeah. Okay. So you read the signs well, very good. So now we'll move on to the next segment.
Okay.
So which world champion was a good baritone singer? Tigran Petrosian, Mikhail Botvinnik, Glenn Steinitz, and Vasily Smyslov.
Okay, my guess is Smyslov. I think he was associated with music, but I don't know if he was a singer or not. So, but I don't remember any of the others being associated with music. So, I think I'll go with Smyslov.
You will go with
Mika is also nodding. So, okay, fine.
Oh, so you got help.
Actually, as part of my homework, the only person I Googled was Smyslov. And I noted he's a baritone singer.
Nice, nice.
This is the question. I have a feeling you know the answer to this question already. Which world-class chess player was also a concert pianist?
Okay, Soumya just answered this. She helped me while answering her last question. So, she told me it's Mark Taimanov. And I believe while doing research on Smyslov yesterday, something was mentioned about Taimanov also into this. So anyways, Soumya has clarified it's Mark Taimanov. So thanks, Soumya, for answering the question before it came. So the answer is Mark Taimanov.
Yes, that's right. The answer is Mark Taimanov. Okay. Now the
My
next,
task was easier.
yeah. So the next question is slightly different. Here there will be two questions coming one after the other, but this is for both of you. Like whoever gets to know the answer first has to, you know, raise the peace and say that you know the answer. So it's like that.
So it's like fastest finger first, right? That kind of.
That kind, yes.
Okay.
Remember that you will not be allowed to use Google Lifeline.
Okay. So we can just put the piece up even if we don't know the answer, like just use
Yeah, you
it.
can. Yes. Who is he? So there will be two stages where I will be giving you a clue. First, he was born on 21st February 1887. He received Grandmaster title in 1950. He carried an old hat with him from tournament to tournament and would only wear it on the last round, and he would win. In 1929, the organizers of the Barcelona tournament asked him to create a new variation in homage to the area's chess history. So he started with d4, knight f6, c4, e6, and played g3, and it is known as Catalan today. Who is this player? You will get the next set of clues only if you choose a lifeline.
Okay, what are the lifelines, by the way? Can you remind me, please?
Yeah, you can actually here phone a friend is the only lifeline which I think is appropriate.
Okay. I don't have any friend who will know this. Can I call you?
I think you can flip, but because this question is to both of you, so even she has a choice here.
My coach will know it, but I'm not sure he's free now to call him. So, like, preventive sir will be probably definitely been knowing it, I guess. But I mean, there's a good chance he'll be knowing it, but I'm not sure
Okay.
he's free now for me to use the phone of lifeline. I mean, he has his classes, so not
Okay.
sure
No other friend
I
comes
want
to
to show
mind.
it. Just give me a minute. Like, can I just ponder on it for a minute?
Yes,
Born on
yes.
21st. Was he a world
So it's like this, like I have given you four pointers, and if you want more clue, you just have to use a lifeline.
This hat thingy is sounding familiar, but
Yeah, it's a very very famous
is
story.
it a famous player or
Yeah, he's a
like,
famous player. That is why I picked you know,
is
because
it
I
like
felt
Taimano? I don't know the year and all. No, when year was Taimano of there? I don't know the year.
Did you know
So,
that, you know, Catalan
one.
had this history?
Oh yeah, that Catalan
You both play
thingy
Catalan, I think. You both have played Catalan.
also. I like Catalan, but I don't know. I mean, there are some names coming to mind, but I just don't know who is it. So it's okay. I mean, I can take a guess because anyway, I don't know the answer. So.
Chemistry
1887. I think it could be Roy
1887.
Lopez. I mean, he's the only
Actually,
Spanish player I can think of who's like born in that era. Like 1887 is a really long time ago.
but why is he Spanish? He's
no,
Spanish,
he's not
right?
Spanish.
Okay, he's not
He's in the
as
organizers of the Barcelona tournament, but not mentioned that, that player is from Spain, so
Okay, I thought maybe he's from Spain, that's why he played in Barcelona or something.
GM title in 1950. 50. Scotch.
87. So perhaps
Born in 87, push. No.
Stenitz, Wilhelm Stenitz. He's. Oh no,
No, but
late.
T7
No.
is already world champion
Oh yeah, T7 is
around.
already the world champion, so
Right.
he can't.
Yes. So not him.
So now Nisha Mohta has decided to call Grandmaster Praveen Tipse for help. So we are letting her use the lifeline call a chess friend.
Hello. Hello, Praveen. Good evening.
Good evening.
I'm now actually in Niranjan's show, Chessophile show, and we are having a quiz. I'm here with Niranjan and Soumya. And there's a question. I need your help. So it is, who is he? So I have some points. He was born on 21st Feb 1887. He received grandmaster title in 1950. He carried an old hat with him from tournament to tournament and would only wear it on the last round, and he would win. In 1929, the organizers of the Barcelona tournament asked him to create a new variation in homage to the area's chess history. So he started with d4, knight f6, c4, e6, and played g3, and is known as Catalan today.
And I have also given the second clue.
Yes, I got the point.
Okay, I have one more clue. I think he said stalemate is the tragicomedy of chess. And he visited a Bronx zoo in 1924, and an orangutan named Susan inspired him to come up with first move b4. First move b4, yes. Kisne nikala hai?
Tata Kaur.
Yeah?
Yes, b4, Tata Kaur.
So should I lock? He became a grandmaster in 1950.
That I didn't know so late. That's the only thing I didn't know.
Okay. Okay, so I will go with, I think I should go with Provincer's yes. Recommendation of
the answer is Tata Kaur. Right. It is right? Dr. Savili Tata Kaur. Right.
Wow. Thank you so much. Thank you. Your answer is correct. Thank you, Pravinji. Yeah. Okay. Bye. Wow.
That was fun.
Yeah.
It was fun. Wow. That was really nice. I mean, we learned a lot of things. I mean, I had heard this hat thingy. But somehow I didn't remember at all. And yeah, B4, I thought something he could find out. Wow, amazing. Great.
Yeah.
He was the doctor of animals, is it? Tata Kaur? Veterinary doctor?
I'm not sure, but he has got doctorate because there is a doctor attached to his name. If you see his Wikipedia, you will see.
No, I just thought because he visited, like he got inspired by orangutan. So
no, chess players visited a zoo, and in the reports it's written that, you know, when he visited the zoo, the way this orangutan moves, that jump somehow inspired him to play b4, like pawn b2 to b4, that kind of a jump.
Okay.
So that's the story. Okay, so now we'll come to the next question. So he was born on 8th March 1925. He received Grandmaster title in 1952. He was the coach to world champion Boris Spassky and Anatoly Karpov. In his native city, Odessa, a street is named after him, and he had plus scores over Bobby Fischer and Mikhail Botvinnik.
Okay, I just have a guess, but I'm not sure.
Yes, your guess is?
Furman. I don't know how to pronounce his name, but F-U-R-M-A-N, Furman.
Are you sure?
That's my guess. Because I know that he was Karpov's coach, and I think he also worked with Spassky. That's why. That's the only
connection you are saying.
Yeah. Everything else I'm not sure of. But these two things, I think I read it somewhere. I mean, a Karpov's coach for sure, but I think he also worked with Spassky.
So. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
This is a moment, I think, which requires some thinking.
Okay, fine. I'll think. Was Spassky and Karpov's coach? Okay, I'll try. I'll probably call Ganguly Bhaiya, Surya Ganguly.
Okay.
I think he might know. So I'll try and call him.
Can't.
I think he's busy. Yeah, he's busy. No
Okay.
luck. Oh God, I'm not able to recollect all of Karpov's coaches. So it's like all of their coaches. Like that's my only clue. Everything else
Okay.
I have no idea about.
Okay, so I'll give you the second clue then.
Okay.
So Botvinnik once said before dash, I mean before that player's name, we did not understand the King's Indian defense.
Okay. Okay, yeah, I'll guess.
Okay.
Mikhail Tal.
I'll give you another clue. He was a consultant to Garry Kasparov also.
Can I make a guess?
Yes.
Bronstein.
There is a famous show in which
I'm completely
this
blank.
player's there is a character with this player's surname. American TV show.
Ah, really?
Yeah.
Okay, that's a good clue, but I don't watch many American shows. Let's see.
Have you watched Friends?
Yeah, I have.
What, Friends?
Yes.
There's a character in Friends.
There's a character in Friends.
Oh, okay, fine. Okay, I got it. I got it. I got it. I got it.
Okay.
Geller.
Yes, Geller is the right answer.
Yeah.
Yes.
When you're put on the spot, you just forget everything.
Yeah.
Right.
That's normal.
I think I knew about Kim Chen. Like, I mean, when you said Kim Chen, I was like, my coach is going to tell me, what is this? He's a permanent Kings Indian player. He's mentioned it so many times, but I just forgot. So.
Yeah. You both almost, you knew the answers to almost all the questions. Except for this, the last part. But
yeah,
okay,
I think the last two questions were very tough. And I had no idea Geller had a plus score over Fischer and Botvinnik. So this
yeah.
is...
Yeah. So that is
so the Kings Indian thing was the clue, I guess. It was a big clue. I mean, I think that is something I should have got. Because I studied Geller's games in Kings Indian. I forgot. So.
Okay. So that is the reason why, you know, his book of best games is titled The Nemesis, because he has been a nemesis of so many players.
Oh, I did not know about this book. Thank
That's
you.
It's worth studying.
Okay.
Okay,
Thank
now
you.
We move on to the chess section, which is like pure chess. And I'm going to give you two puzzles. So are you ready for study?
Okay, fine. We are ready.
This first question is to Soumya. And
okay.
It is why to play and win.
Okay.
Let's see if you can solve this within a minute.
Okay. Okay, I got it. So shall I tell the answer?
Wow, okay, please go on.
So first move is king f5 and queen moves somewhere is forced. So maybe queen g8 or queen f8. Queen g8 is knight f6, so queen f8 is forced.
Okay.
So knight g7 check, queen into g7, bishop e8 check, queen g6, pawn bishop into g6, pawn into g6, king f6, pawn g5 is forced, king f5, pawn g4 is forced, and h into g.
H into g4 is a checkmate, right? So that was a killer pawn.
Yeah, nice.
Nice. That was very quick.
Okay, thanks.
So you know, when you play on chess.com and if you checkmate by a pawn, then you get this trophy, like achievement, that you're.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So have you ever got like have you got this mate with a pawn in your board in chess.com?
No, clearly not, because otherwise I would have known about it.
Ah, okay. All right. So we'll now go to the next question, and this is to Didi. Try to play and win.
No, I'm kind of trying to think, consider some forced moves as I see it's a study.
So do you both like solve studies as part of your regular?
Yes, actually, since this lockdown started, and I know that I don't need to play any regular tournaments for quite some time.
Mm-hmm.
This was something in my to-do list for a long time. I wanted mm-hmm. to improve my calculation and my studies. Mm-hmm. So, solving of studies. So I have started doing it on a very regular basis. So I need to really do it now.
Okay. So what about you, Soumya? Do you also solve a lot of studies?
Not as much as I would like. There was a period in between I used to solve every day, and I solved this book by Casperon, this 24-2558.
Domination.
Domination, yeah. That one I solved. And after that, I stopped. But I want to solve. So now, since yesterday, I got into a habit to solve again.
Okay.
And now you are giving a study, but it's slightly difficult when you are not in
touch.
Yeah, you are not doing it regularly, then it's difficult. But once you get into the rhythm, it's very easy to, easy, but it's easier to find ideas. Yeah.
Right.
And it's like any other part of chess. The more you practice, the easier it gets.
Yeah.
Okay, here I'm kind of considering b4, king a4 first, knight b2, king a3, knight c4, king a4, bishop mm-hmm. c2, king b5, and now I need to find some punches, what I feel,
mm-hmm.
what am I missing? I mean, this is my calculation right now, I could be wrong, but that's
yes,
where
b4,
I feel.
Yes, king a4, you're saying knight b2, king a3, knight c4, knight king a4.
Yeah, this is where I'm considering bishop c2. Maybe there is
bishop
something.
C2, king b5.
B5, that's where I'm stuck up right now. And maybe I'm in wrong direction already, or is it?
So you are in that position where black queen is on a6, king is on b5, and white knight is on c4, and bishop is on c2.
Yeah, and I'm thinking, I hope I'm on the right track. Otherwise, I need to at least come back one move. I think b4, king a4, knight b2, king a3, knight c4, king a4 is just forced.
Okay.
I don't see there's nothing in between. Bishop c2 more or less looks like first only.
Oh, Soumya, have you got the answer?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay. So you can show the knight.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, okay. Though it is her turn, so we are waiting for her to finish her variation.
Yeah, sure. Actually, it's very pretty. I think viewers should also try and solve it.
Am I correct till bishop c2 or not, Soumya?
Yeah, you're correct.
So bishop c2, king b5 is correct, right?
Yeah.
Now I'm feeling there has to be some punch here. Some sacrifice coming up here. What is it? What am I missing? Sorry. I'm missing something. Bishop c2, king b5. What do I do? Candidate moves. Knight d6 is one. Bishop a4. Desperate things I'm considering first. Knight d6, king c6, b5. Is it over? No, knight c6, king c6, b5, queen into b5. What is it? No, what I need a pawn. Bishop e4, king c5, knight b7.
Right.
Yes. Oh, got it finally.
Yes.
Okay. That was very pretty.
Yes.
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 Nice.
So have you both got a chance to checkmate with knight and bishop in the tournament?
I think yes, but I can't remember. I mean, definitely I would have got. I mean, you mean only bishop, knight, king? I mean, checkmate with bishop and knight, or any
Yes.
position?
No, like you start the count of moves, like you start counting.
No, I haven't.
Oh, you
Ah.
haven't.
Start count.
Okay.
You mean bishop and knight mate? No, I don't remember. But maybe I would have got it. It's a long. It's, you know, I have a long career, so I can't
Okay.
remember whether I got it or not. So yeah.
All right. Okay. Now we move to the battle zone. It's
Okay.
puzzle rush time.
Okay, fine. Let's go.
Please go to your respective chess.com accounts.
Okay.
The puzzle rush has started.
Water in my mouth.
Are you ready for the second round?
Okay, we have another, we have a rematch, yeah?
Yeah, this is best of two. That is why question 9 and question 10, right?
Okay.
Nice. Yeah.
Okay. So
Yeah.
rematch, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Rematch is good because then you get a chance. Like, I also get a chance, but both of us get a chance, basically.
Right. Is the second round of the puzzle battle.
Thank you.
Okay, so Soumya takes this in puzzle battle. So
Okay.
before I go to that last segment, here is something from my side to Soumya Swaminathan and Nisha Mohta. Hello.
Sweet. Thank you. That's so sweet.
Yes, you're welcome.
I really like it. I'll print it out
Yes.
in my room.
Nice.
Definitely, yes.
Yes.
So this
Thank
is
you.
like a souvenir.
Yeah.
Yes. By
Very.
the way, Anjan, I want to add that I really like your logo. It's very pretty, just Chessophile logo. It's
Yes.
very nice. I really like the design of it.
Yes, all my posts, like the blog posts that I write, everything has the same pattern. So I've been
Okay.
maintaining it right from last year, September.
Okay. Okay.
So
We had a
right.
plan to do this show anyway. Like it was on your mind or it happened
Yes.
organically? Okay.
No, I wanted to do this show I think 2 years back, and I had approached a company also, and
Okay.
I did not receive a reply with the idea, but then I decided someday I will make it on my own, and then this lockdown period, you know, gave me that chance because I had some time, so I thought I could do it.
Yeah, it's a good way to seek opportunity from challenges.
Yes. Okay, so that was the souvenir. Now coming to the last part. Do you have anybody to thank, or do you have some words for your fans, followers, anything that you have, like a message? You can say it now. You can use this as a platform. You can go first, Soumya. Have anybody to
Actually,
thank?
before I thank anyone, I have a question for you.
Okay.
So you've been writing books, as people who follow this show might know already. Like, or if they don't, then Niranjan has been writing books, and they are usually fiction books, I guess. Like, you've written
Yes.
3 books so far, right? And I wanted to know if you're going to like does chess feature in any of them, or are you planning to write a book on this theme?
Yes, thanks for that question. Regarding chess, yes, I am currently writing a book, but I have also written chess-oriented, let's say chess fiction before, and it is on my blog profile in chess.com,
Okay.
where I have written about pandas. Let's say group of pandas decide to learn chess because
Oh, nice.
chess. So, like, group of pandas decide to learn chess because that is the only way they can survive. Like it happens in Lagan, like he has to learn cricket to, you know, survive, and he has to beat them and get the land and tax-free thing in Lagan. Something like that for pandas, where they learn chess, and then there is let's say one book which helps them, but that book is very stubborn. It opens to only those who are very devoted to the game. So it's like that. It's
That's the story.
Yeah.
It's very nice. Very cute.
So
Yeah.
I've written it in such a way that once you start reading the story, by the end of it, you will end up learning basics of chess.
Oh,
So
that's a
that way.
wonderful. Oh, that's a wonderful way to introduce someone to chess, I think.
Yes. So primarily, I wrote this as a birthday gift to a kid, and then I have stopped it at part 5. So after part 5, I haven't written. Like once the basics are introduced, after that, I haven't written.
I think I'll also gift it to one of my nieces or nephews. I have a lot of nieces and
Yes,
nephews.
so it's titled Chess for Pandas. It's available on chess.com, my chess.com profile.
Okay, I see.
Actually,
Yes.
I kind of flipped through it. I mean, I've not read it, but I kind of chanced upon it and just saw like Chess for Pandas little, but I opened for a minute. I thought it is my, you know, something. It's in my to-do list to read it, kind of. So yeah, nice.
Okay. Yeah, so
Lovely.
that answers your question.
Thank you
Yeah.
for sharing this with all.
Okay. Now coming back to you. So you were about to say something.
No, actually, I just want to thank everybody who's watching this, first of all, for taking out the time and, you know, being curious enough to find out more about how chess players think and basically following chess. It means a lot to chess players to have people who follow the game and who cheer for us. If like any other sports persons, we also really are very grateful to have spectators and chess lovers who follow the games and follow our follow us maybe. So thank you to everyone, and that's all. I mean, that's the main thing.
Now coming to Didi, so what about you?
You've given me a question. I can answer it for, I don't know, next 1 hour. Like you have asked, you know, the people I would like to thank. Mm-hmm. And the list in my life, you know, list of such people is endless. But still, I would like to mention a few whom I would really like to thank in mm-hmm. my life. Okay, first of all, to all the viewers who are watching this mm-hmm. show. But apart from that, like in my career, there are a lot of people I need to thank. Mm-hmm. So once you've given me a platform, why not use it? So yes. First of all, of course, my parents who have literally given up their lives to, you know, make us, you know, make me and my elder sister Swati Mota both a player. They have
yes.
done everything that was possible for them. And I think more than what was possible for them, basically. Apart from them, my school, Mahadevi Birla Shishu Vihar, mm-hmm. I was in one of the Birla schools. And if it was, you know, not for my school, I wouldn't be a player.
Mm-hmm.
They supported me immensely. And mm-hmm. Even my school exams, you know, they would take it sometimes later on. Like, for example, when I became a Women International Master in mm-hmm. 1995, I had my class 8 final exams. And they took a re-exam for me. This, my, you know, the school authorities told me, you have to go and play chess. You cannot miss chess tournaments. So I went, I played the tournament, came back and wrote exams. And, you know, this was not today's date. It was 1995. So yes. I mean, my school has played a very
huge
important
support.
Yes, huge support from my school. Apart from my parents and my school. Okay, there is a long list, but I'll jump to the current day. Like, you know, whom I want to thank in the present day situation. There are 4 people currently who help me during my tournaments, either emotionally or in chess or whatever way. So I have a, you know, we all need a very good support system,
yes.
especially female players. We have this, I mean, men also need, but more so for female, because we need emotional support also along with chess support. And I'm very lucky. I have not one, but 4 such people who are in my life and who have helped me selflessly, you know, like really supported me whenever I needed.
Mm-hmm.
And one is Praveen Thipse. He has mm-hmm. been my coach. He's more of a mentor. I go to him when I have like real problems, kind
mm-hmm.
of.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, I work with my friends. So Praveen sir, Praveen Thipse,
mm-hmm.
His wife Bhagyashree Thipse, who's been my practice partner since I think forever. So, and also Kiran Manisha Mohanty, she's my competitor. But whenever I need support, she's there for me, even if she's playing the same tournament. Like, you know, there are times I am, like, it's very rare that you have a competitor who is playing the tournament and is still there to help you or uplift your mood or help you in chess. I mean, even though she's playing a tournament. And last but not the least, I want to thank you.
Mm-hmm.
You've always been there for me. And I mean, this is, and I got this platform. I was not sure. I'm not sure I should be telling it here. But yes, I'm really thankful to you.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Always being there for me.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, for the viewers, Niranjan has helped me in chess, in, you can say, if I'm down or if I need some help regarding to what do I do related to a DVD I'm going to release or a video project which I need. Like literally everywhere Niranjan has been there. So thank you for being there.
Yeah, yeah. You're welcome. So, I mean, we know each other, I think, for more than 15 years now already, right?
Yes. In fact, for the viewers, something very special, like the boy sitting in front of you hosting this show right now, I met him when he was 10. And I mean, for me, it is a surprise that I wrote a poem on him when he was 10.
Yes.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Oh. Yes.
Yes. I mean, I met him. There was something so special about him that I just wrote a poem on him. And yeah, it's been a long journey. And the words of the poem, the first few words were like, "I met a boy of 10. I think he'll be a great man. There is something wonderful in his eyes, which makes me look at him twice." These are starting lines of
Yes, so
the
this was in Sangli.
Yes, this was in Sangli. Niranjan was there with his mother.
Right.
So
Okay, that was great. So also a big shout out to a secret grandmaster who has helped me with putting the questions. He's a grandmaster and doesn't want to be revealed, so he's an anonymous secret grandmaster. And who has helped me in putting the questions for this show? So big shout out to him. Thank you.
Yes, very nice questions, very interesting questions, actually.
Yes, I
Yes.
completely enjoyed this show. It was amazing. And we learned something, some new things, especially that guessing question where we use the phone of friend, where I use the phone of friend lifeline. That
Yes.
question was very nice. Yeah.
Yes.
And I just
Okay.
want to add that apart from people, I think chess itself has given us so much that we have a lot to thank chess for.
Yes,
It's
true.
played so many roles in our life, not just as a profession, but as a friend, as an anchor. So even during these times of COVID, I think it is chess that keeps us going and be
True, yeah.
positive. So
Right.
yeah, I think, yeah, that's all.
Okay. So it was wonderful having both of you. First of all, thanks for accepting my invitation and then, being very patient throughout the show with all the settings.
No, thank
So,
you so much, Niranjan, for having us. It was a lot of fun, actually.
yeah, and
We got
thanks, Niranjan. I got to meet Soumya after a very long time, and I love being with her anytime. So yeah.
Yeah.
It was a good opportunity for us to catch up with each other.
Yes.
Okay. I'm glad this happened. So thank you then. We can call it an end.
Okay. Thank
Okay
you.
then.
Bye.
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 Chessophile Show.
Chessophile Show.
Chessophile Show.
The Chessophile Show.